them. In this Christian world where it's so hard to get people to help needy people, you ask them to help needy people and they curse you, they get mad at you, they snarl at you. You ask them to pray for people and they get mad, they don't want to do it. You ask them to give testimonies, they don't want to do it. It's just a lukewarm Christian world today. It's called the Laodicean church age today, like it was back in Laodicea. Let me read the scripture here. This is what Jesus would tell people. Matthew 25, verse 34. Then the king, this is Jesus, would say to those on his right hand, "Come, you blessed of my Father, inherited to the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger, and you took me in. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me." He would go on. "I was dying in sin and on the way to hell, and you preached the word of God to me. You told me what sins were. You told me how to pray and how to get free from those sins, so I was able to change my life and get the sin out of my life so I could go to heaven." He would say that anything that we've done to help people, to preach the word of God to them, to get people saved, we've done for Jesus ourselves. And we need to constantly be doing that, making an impact, changing the world for Jesus, helping the needy and getting people saved. Then he would say over in verse 44, "Then they will also answer him," these are the other people, "saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not minister to you?" And he will answer them saying, "As surely as I say to you, inasmuch as you did it not to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me." And these will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. So the people that haven't helped people, the people that haven't prayed for people, that haven't got people saved, that haven't preached the word of God to their friends and to the people of the world, Jesus is going to tell them that he never knew them and they're not going to make it to heaven. So it's so important. We're called to be watchmen. If we don't warn people how they're living, and of their sin, of their lukewarmness, of their idleness, then we'll be held accountable for that also. You can read that in the book of Ezekiel. So let's go out there and do something each day for the kingdom of God and live for Jesus as we help people, preach the word of God to them, take care of the needy. We're doing it for Jesus himself. And I love you all, and God bless you, and have a good day.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Boyd, once again for calling in and being faithful with just a little thing like a phone call. But man, you can feel the anointing transfer through the phone line and out of the speakers into the lost and dying world. If you're listening tonight and you don't know this man we're talking about, that we're singing about and we're praising, yes, Jesus Christ, well, you need him. You see, you can't make it to heaven without him. No, you got to have Jesus Christ. You must be born again or you will in no wise see the kingdom of heaven, my friend. Won't you reach out right now, right there where you're at, and get things settled between you and God, my friend. Get it done. Take care of business. I mean, rise up a new creature tonight. Amen. You know, don't be like you're looking. You know, don't be like you see those hypocrites. Don't be like those false prophets. Don't be like them liars and whoremongers and thieves. And don't be like them. Come out from amongst the world and be ye a separated people. Man, you stand up for Christ. You put your hands on the plow. Don't look back. Be a doer of the word of God. As you read the word of God, apply it into your life. Not being a hearer only, but a doer of the word of God. And God will bless you. He will bless you. He will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out blessings that you cannot describe, my friend. It's better felt than it is told. Reach out. Take a hold of that unchanging hand of the great I Am. Won't you do that right now? And just allow God to shape you into what he would have you to be, my friend. For we are the clay and he is the potter. Jump on the potter's wheel and allow God to mold you and shape you and anoint you and send you forth into a lost and dying world. Amen. All right. Hey, thank you once again for hanging out with us right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. It is Bluegrass Night. Amen. And we're just praising God. That's what we do all the time. Amen. Praise God. If you get a chance, you want to check out the other program we done a little earlier, the Bread of Life Gospel Singers. Check that program out. Get the numbers. Call them. Be a blessing. And just let them know that you heard their music right here on the Gospel Music Jukebox. Take a minute. Take a minute and be a blessing. I mean, I know you're busy. You're like me. We're busy. We're doers. We're always, our hands are at something for the kingdom of God. Well, add that to your list of do things. Say, I'm going to start calling somebody and just tell them how much the Lord loves them. Amen. And watch what happens. Man, I'm telling you, it's awesome when God is in control. Amen. It's just awesome. There's no other way to describe it. Praise God. But God is good. Even when we don't understand what's going on, even when we don't feel like He's moving in our lives, He is. Yeah, we're healed. Even when it don't feel like it, we're healed. Even when it don't look like it, we're healed. Even when the doctors say it's impossible, we're healed. Because we know the God of impossibles. And it's, amen. That's how good He is. I'm telling you, He's good now. Praise God. God, I mean, besides Him, there is none other. Amen. Okay, we got John Bennett says, I need prayers for my family. Lord knows all about it. Let's do that right now. Dear Heavenly Father, God, You know the needs of Your people. Lord, for You search the reins of our heart. Lord, we speak Your word, Your promises into this situation, Lord. We claim victory for John Bennett's family. Right now, we plead the blood, Your precious blood, over this situation. Satan, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus, the only begotten Son of God. Satan, you are a liar. And we stand firm in the anointing and the blood of Jesus, and we speak such as we ought to. Satan, take your hands off of God's property right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we speak peace, love, sanctification, and salvation. In the name of Jesus, we speak healing right now into John Bennett's family. Right now, in Jesus' name, it's so, it's settled, it's finished, because we are healed from the bottom of our feet to the top of our head. Not by nothing we do, but by the blood of Christ, our precious Lord and Savior. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. All right. God bless. We'll jump right back into some music right here and just raise our hands up and just thank God, because besides Him, there is none other, my friends. Be blessed in Jesus' name.
You may join a heavenly choir and rejoice with Him, free from every sin, when He sets this world on fire. Won't you take advice, make the sacrifice, completely turn from sin, taking up thy cross, counting earth as dross, let Jesus live within. When temptations come, you can face towards home, your heart will never tire. But rejoice and pray on the last great day when He sets this world on fire.
If you don't from sin retire, He will set your fields on fire. You have heard the Jesus call, and in death your soul must fall. Now my friends, if you desire, you may join the heavenly choir
and rejoice with Him, free from every sin. When He sets this world on fire. Thank you.
Amen. Praise God. All right. I think I seen a while ago. I have to go over here and look. Amen. I do got it. I just have to find it. Amen. I believe it was Petey wanting a long black train. Amen. I believe it was. Long black train. I believe. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I believe it was. All right. Let's see if we can get that going. Hold on just a second.
There's a long black train coming down the line, feeding off the souls that are lost and crying. Rails of sin, only evil remains. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. Look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption staring back into your eyes. There is protection and there's peace the same. Burn in your ticket for that long black train. Cause there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory. If the ride is worth the pain, he's just waiting on your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say, victory.